Welcome, everybody. It's What a Joke with Papa and Fortune. Good morning, Fortune.
Hey, Tom.
How was your weekend?
It was good. Just had some ice cream, called Mama.
You look so pretty today.
Well, I just started testosterone.
What? Why would you do that?
I went to a longevity doctor that Rogan had told me I should go to.
Wait, what?
Yeah.
Do I sound like Fortune at all?
You kind of do.
My name is Bert Kreischer.
It's Bert Kreischer, everybody. Bert is here.
Look who showed up.
On the big day. How dare you? He's here on the big day. His special is airing on Netflix today.
Whoa.
Razzle Dazzle.
Razzle Dazzle.
Give him the old Razzle Dazzle.
I love talking about my health.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I'm super aggressive about getting blood work. I go to the cardiologist every 6 months. He said casually, have you ever thought about getting on testosterone? And I went, I know, but I have a bunch of friends that do it.
Yeah.
And he goes, you may want to get on testosterone. It's really good for your recovery, your sleep,
whoa,
your energy levels. But more importantly, it repairs livers. So like it'll reverse fatty liver.
No.
And I went, for real? I go, that's all you had to say. I started yesterday. I have like a whole regimen.
Man, so when does he say that it'll take, like you'll start to feel the effects?
I lost 5 pounds yesterday.
Yesterday?
I lost five pounds.
That's crazy.
Wow. Your body was just like, I'm repairing itself immediately?
Yeah, I don't know.
Pee it out?
I slept amazing.
I have the question everyone's thinking.
Shoot.
How does it affect that old wiener?
Oh, it's going to be at full steam.
No, Leanne's in Vietnam, so I wouldn't know. I don't know.
They say it's supposed to make it back to its old days.
Really?
No. It's out of retirement.
Oh.
That's why I'm curious.
No more bike rides for Leanne. Good luck going to yoga, honey.
She's about to get the razzle dazzle.
Yeah.
Razzle dazzle.
Yeah. What do you think of the name?
I love the name.
I love it.
I'm name heavy on specials.
Yeah.
I had Secret Time's the best name of any special I ever had because it was so in my lexicon.
Right.
And you still say it all the time.
I say it all the time.
Yeah.
I think I might have just said it
you
out.
Just said it out
I
there.
Just said
yeah.
it out there.
You did.
Yeah, because I love secrets. I love secrets.
Right.
My buddy the other day called me and he told me, can I tell you a secret? And I was like, oh, I'm the wrong guy. I go, but of course I go, yeah. And he goes, my wife can't give a blowjob at all. And I don't know how to approach this with her. And I was like, I don't know. And so I go home, I see Leanne, and immediately I'm like, Tom said Christina can't give a blowjob. Oh, shit, did I say the name? Okay, anyway. No, I'm joking.
To be clear, it's a different Tom, yeah. Just to be clear.
And a different Christina.
Segura. So Secret Time is my favorite name of a special. I loved Hey Big Boy because it's what my daughters called me. And then I named the tour the Birdie Boy Tour.
Mm-hmm.
And I was crazy about naming the name of Birdie Boy Tour is only Leanne and my sisters would call me Birdie Boy. Now my daughters call me Big Boy, but they would call me Birdie Boy, and they were the only ones who called me Birdie Boy, and it meant that they loved me. It was like an endearment.
Yeah.
And then fans started seeing me like, hey, Birdie Boy, and it made me feel like the way when my sisters said it. So it was like fucking awesome.
Aww.
I loved it. And then this one, I've been saying Razzle Dazzle an aggressive amount of times in my life. I do it when I go to McDonald's. I'll give them $200 and go, Razzle Dazzle.
And they just like fill the bag up with a bunch of stuff?
Yeah, Razzle Dazzle. You know what? Like appetizers, Razzle Dazzle. Like I just wanted to feel Razzle Dazzle.
Uh-huh.
And so I do it with everything.
Where did it start?
It started on Trip Flip, my Travel Channel show. We would go out to eat with a group of 11,
uh-huh,
and the waitress would come over. We were working with this guy once, this older guy, John Burston, and he was a straight dude, but he was a little flamboyant.
Uh-huh.
You know, like you got to throw money at it. You got to spend money to make money.
Right.
You know, that's the way he talked, and it was fun. And they came over one time, and they go, what do you guys want for appetizer? He goes, oh, Razzle Dazzle. and I've said it ever since. It was like my favorite moment. And so I always do it. And this guy, John Burston, I learned a great deal from this guy. But he was just a fun.
Yeah.
Oh, Razzle Dazzle. The way he said it was so funny that I started saying it in my life. When we go, and especially we did the Hot Summer Night Tour, because we were with a group of like 10 in the bus,
uh-huh,
we'd go into a McDonald's and I didn't want to spend the time to get everyone to take an order.
Yeah.
Right.
So I'd give them $200 and just go Razzle Dazzle.
And they would do it?
They
just... I mean, a bunch of stuff in there.
I just did it the other night. I literally did it the other night.
My dream. I love people surprising me with just a bunch of food.
I used to go with Ari and a bunch of comics to Salt Lake Park City to go skiing.
Yeah.
And there's one of the taco places, not the good one, but the second to good one.
Del Taco?
Del Taco. There's a Del Taco. God, wow. Wow. You should understand your branding, Del Taco.
The second.
Number two, good one. A reason.
Del Taco, of course. You can't find Taco Bell. Yeah.
What's the second one?
And you want fries.
And so we were coming back from Wise Guys, and we were high as shit, and we were drunk. And I go, pull over. We were in a car, in a taxi. And he's like, what? I go, pull over. We're getting tacos. And the guy in the cab, he goes, what do you guys want to order? And I just go, tell him, Razzle Dazzle, $200. And they go, guy goes, Razzle Dazzle, $200. The guy goes, go ahead and pull forward. And we ate tacos for 3 days.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
Bert, does Razzle Dazzle have other meaning, like other than food?
It's anything that makes anything special. I live my life, I was going to write a self-help book because more people are like me than are like David Goggins.
Right.
Like, so, and I was like, and I've succeeded. Mm-hmm. And people probably could figure out my path to success quicker than his path.
Right.
His path is run 50 miles every morning when you wake up. A lot of people don't have that in them.
Yeah.
But a lot of people can figure out, like, the first chapter of my self-help book was give yourself a nickname. Like you need, because you need like a persona, and then that persona will be really attached to who you actually are, and you blur the lines,
right.
And then you actually become the superhero you want to be.
Right.
I'm the machine. I'm the machine.
I'm the machine.
I'm the machine. Like I'm the machine. I'm the machine. I get up. I got up at 6:30 this morning. Took my pills. Got in the gym. We did squats.
Shit yourself.
I pissed myself in the gym. And then I come here, I do this. I have a podcast right after this. I have a pitch, Judd, after that. And then I have Fighter and the Kid down in the, what you call it? But I work all day long.
Yeah. Right.
I partied last night. I had wine with my parents. I got a haircut during that. Like, I love cramming stuff in.
Now, were you always that way? Or was it
no.
Once the nickname got in, you kind of, like you said, start evolving into that active guy?
Well, I think when the nickname showed up, I would, when the mob would say, like, tonight we party with the machine.
Yeah.
I would step it up a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
But
right.
What happened was when Rogan was the first one to really kind of cement that nickname.
Uh-huh.
And he would say phrases like, God, you are the machine. Like, and I would be like, yeah, I am. And then I would believe it. I would believe it. And so when I ran the LA marathon with no training,
which was crazy.
I was like, yeah, I'm the machine. I'll do whatever I want.
Right.
And then I did it. And when I did it, I started saying, you know, I have a great story with Rogan. I was drunk on a motorcycle in Vietnam, running through rice paddies like at like 60 miles an hour in dirt roads.
Right.
And I was listening to The Doors, and I was high, and I was drunk, and I was, the sun was setting, there's oxen on each side of me, and my shirt's wide open, I have flip-flops on, I'm on an old Russian Ural, ooh, and I'm flying, and he called me in the middle. I'm working for Travel Channel, and he goes, and my phone rings, my headsets are in. Yeah. I pull over. I said, what's up, buddy? And he goes, what are you doing right now? I said, I'm running motorcycles through rice paddies in Vietnam, drunk and high. And he's quiet for like 3 seconds, and he goes, shit, you are the machine. And he's like, you know, man, he goes, you got to quit this Travel Channel show. This is who you are. It's not the guy that's hosting the show. It's this guy right here.
Right.
This guy who's living his life
right.
and doing wild shit. That's who you are. And if you don't talk about this on stage, you're shortchanging yourself. Mm-hmm. If you just live this life hosting a show on Travel Channel
right.
and don't be the guy drunk and high riding motorcycles through rice paddies in Vietnam and talk about that on stage, then you're shortchanging who you are. It was a very pivotal conversation I had with him.
Yeah.
I remember getting back on that motorcycle and believing it and getting chill bumps and going, I'm the fucking machine. And then I almost wrecked. And then my wife called on the same motorcycle ride.
Uh-huh.
She goes, hey, baby doll, what are you doing? I said, whoa, works so well with Joe. I go, I'm high as shit, I'm drunk as fuck, and I'm running motorcycles through rice paddies in Vietnam. And she's like, you are not the fucking machine. You're a father of two with high blood pressure and high cholesterol. Walk that motorcycle home.
You are baby doll.
You are baby doll. Get the fuck off that car. You do not know how to ride a motorcycle. You have a helmet on. And I was like, I don't have a helmet on.
I'm in flip-flops.